boys and girls. Who can remember what trait we introduced last month? Think.
Remember when that beautiful Miss America was here and she was singing? She introduced something. Do you remember what it is?
I think I hear it. Shout it out.
Respect. Oh my gosh, you're right. Respect.
And do you know that your teachers had a really hard time picking the most respectful students in their classrooms? They said everybody was saying please. Everybody was saying thank you. Everybody was holding the door open for everybody else. They couldn't even believe it. They said, Mrs. Petrini, we can't have this assembly. We don't know who we're going to pick. And I said, you have to pick somebody. And they just didn't know because they said everybody was being respectful. So give yourself a round of applause. You did awesome. You did so, so good. And today we have a superhero here behind me who's going to introduce a new trait. But first, we need to see who was the most respectful. Are you ready?
Yeah.
All right, let's do it. All right, we're gonna start with kindergarten. If you're in kindergarten, raise your hand. Raise your hand. Oh my gosh, really high. Okay, here we go. In kindergarten, Mrs. Coons nominated Luis Lopez. Luis, come on down.
Thank you.
ready? All right, Mr. Martin said the most respectful person in his class is Alina Santiago.
Feeling.
Oh, right. That's what empathy is.
Yes.
I don't get it.
What? Okay, let me see if I can explain it to you in some way.
Okay, I'm gonna listen.
Let's say I'm walking along and, oh!
What?
I stubbed my toe. Oh, that hurts.
Oh, you poor thing.
Larry.
Oh, that hurts. I can imagine exactly how you feel.
That's empathy.
What's empathy?
You could imagine exactly how I feel. You could understand just how it felt. That's empathy.
I still don't get it.
What?
I still don't get it.
Okay. Let's think of another way.
Okay, let's think of another way. Thank you.
Oh, Murray.
What?
Did I tell you about that time when I lost my favorite teddy bear? It was...
Did you love that teddy bear?
I love that teddy bear.
Oh, I can imagine exactly how you feel. It's really sad feeling. It makes me want to cry with this.
It was sad. It was so sad. But you know what? You know what empathy is.
I do?
That was empathy.
What?
You can understand how I was feeling, exactly how I was feeling, and understood it. That's empathy.
I get it now. Yes! Yes, I get it!
Yes!
I understand empathy!
You understand empathy,
I'm
Murray.
I'm so happy right now.
I'm
happy
too.
I want to dance the dance of happiness.
I can imagine exactly how you feel. I want to dance the dance of happiness too.
So what are we waiting for?
Town and in this school, some of you might have had him in the summer, right? Let's say hi to Mr. Josh!
Good morning, everyone. Is everyone here? Everyone's here? Well, good morning, Winslow School. It's so nice that... Oh, no, sorry. Not Winslow School. What school is this?
Rossi.
Okay. Sorry, let's do it again. Good morning, Rossi School. Wonderful. So I want to check if you guys are really here. So I want to ask you to do something really quick. It's super easy. Making sure your eyes and your ears work well. So if you hear me, clap one time. If you see me, clap two times. If you can hear me and see me, clap three times. One, two, three. Beautiful. So this morning, Ms. Petrini asked me to come here to talk to you about a huge word, something very big, something that we don't know a lot about. It's hard to understand. The word is empathy. And she also wanted me to talk about sympathy. Who knows what sympathy means? Can anyone raise their hand? Who knows what sympathy means? My friend right here with the maroon shirt, yes. Do you know what sympathy means? Anyone have an idea? You, what do you think sympathy means?
You say loud?
Well, it's a hard word to understand, but you know what? I'm gonna see if we can find out what sympathy means. So, what if we ask Siri? Can we ask Siri to see what she tells us? All right, let's see if Siri's awake this morning, okay? So can anyone can try to wake up Siri? Can anyone say, hey Siri?
Hey Siri!
She's not responding. Let's try one more time. Can anyone say, hey Siri?
Hey Siri!
I don't know what's wrong with Siri. Let's just do it one more time, please, real quick.
Hey Siri!
Maybe she only listens to me. Let's ask her. Hey Siri. Hey Siri. Hey Siri, what does sympathy mean?
Sympathy means feelings of pity and sorrow for someone else's misfortune. Do you want to hear the next one?
No. So Siri says that sympathy means sorrow for someone else's feelings. That's a big word, sorrow. But you know what sympathy really means? All sympathy means is this. Sympathy says sorry, it feels sorry, but it does nothing. All sympathy can do is say, I'm sorry. When you have sympathy, that means you feel sorry, You feel sorry for the person, you can say you're sorry. That's what sympathy means. So everyone say, sympathy means?
Sympathy.
I'm sorry. And so the big definition that Siri gave us was the feeling that you care about sorrow, someone else's trouble, the grief, misfortune. You're sympathetic. Those are all big words to say that you feel sorry. So what does sympathy mean? Sympathy means I'm
sorry.
So I'm gonna try my best to make you guys feel sorry. So I want you guys to think about the saddest thing ever. Imagine no presents for Christmas. Imagine a poor dog with no home to go to. Imagine there's people on the street. You know what makes us feel sorry sometimes? When you hear a sad song, that makes you feel sorry. So look at this song. This song made me feel very sad this morning. So we're gonna see if we can play it. You guys ready to feel sympathy?
Yeah.
All right. I don't wanna feel it, but it's okay. We're gonna do it. It's okay to cry. It's okay. Anyone felt sorry? Anyone feel sad? Well, congratulations, you just felt sympathy. That's sympathy. All sympathy does is says, I'm sorry. So now we're gonna look at empathy. Anyone know what empathy means? Empathy, what does empathy mean? We just saw the movie, the little show on Sesame Street. Anyone know what empathy means? Anyone? My friend here with the white shirt, come on up. Come on up, quick. What is empathy? Okay, very good. Give it up for our friend over here. Miss Petrini, can you hand this young boy, Miss Petrini, can you hand this young boy a kiss? I want to hand out kisses today for my helpers, so you can give him one. So empathy. Let's see if Siri can tell us what empathy means. Everyone say, hey Siri.
Hey Siri.
Oh, she woke up. Let's see. Hey Siri.
Hey Siri.
What does empathy mean?
The ability to understand and share the feelings of another.
Wonderful. So the ability to understand and feel. So empathy does not only say it's sorry, but it puts itself in someone else's shoes. So I want to show you this really small clip. I want you guys to watch the screen, and we're going to understand what that means to put someone else's shoes on. Did everybody wear their brothers and sisters' shoes this morning? Have you ever worn the wrong shoes by accident? Was it comfortable? Was it? Did anyone ever wear a size too small? Is that comfortable? Maybe some teachers can recognize you wanted that shoe in the store and it didn't feel comfortable, you bought it anyway. When you wear a shoe that's not that belong to you, it's not that comfortable. It feels weird. So putting on someone else's shoes is not always so comfortable. So we're gonna watch this quick little video. I want you guys to pay close attention to putting on someone else's shoes, okay? You guys are doing an awesome job. So while we're waiting for this clip, I actually need a volunteer to come up really quick. Someone really quick to come up. Let's see. Who here wears a size, maybe a size 2 in kids? You know your sizes? Anyone wear size 2? My friend right here, come on up. Come on up. So what is your name?
Richie.
All right, Richie, everyone give it up for Richie. Come on up, Richie. So Richie's gonna be empathy today. He's going to experience someone else's pain. He's gonna experience someone else's struggle. So Richie, I have for you today these size pair of shoes. So why don't you put these on real quick? Put those on, those look like they fit you well. So now guys, what do you think this is? What is this? Let's see, I travel with this. So this is pretty handy when you're in the airport. This cool thing turns into a book bag. This is what I'm talking about. This turns into a book bag. So Richie, you have your shoes on? They're comfortable? A little, right? They're not that bad. All right, Richie, can you hold your book bag? Everyone say book bag. Life. This is life. And Richie is what? Empathy. Everyone say book bag life. Richie's empathy. So Richie's wearing someone else's shoes right now that don't belong to him, but he's trying them on. So Richie, this isn't your life, this is someone else's life, but you're gonna hold life. Remember, book bag is what? Life. And Richie is what? All right. So Richie, today you're going to have to hold someone else's life. So today we're gonna put some stuff in here. So this morning, Richie, this life has a rough morning. This person didn't have any breakfast. This person doesn't have mom and dad at home sometimes. This person couldn't find their book bag. This person has a bad note from the teacher. This person couldn't find their gym clothes. This person missed the bus. This person didn't have his best snack. This person spilled their milk in their book bag. This person didn't get to be picked first for gym. This person didn't get student of the month. All right, let's close that up. Remember, what's book bag? Book bag is what? Life. And Richie is what? Empathy. Okay, we're doing great. All right, close that up, Richie. Put that on, bud. So now Richie is empathy. He's going to walk in someone else's shoes. Remember, these are not his shoes. This is not his life. But he's going to hold it. You got it? You got this. All right. So Richie, can you just walk up and down real quick for me and see how that feels? Let's walk together. Let's walk. Now, all that sympathy can do is say this. I'm so sorry you're holding that heavy book bag. I'm so sorry you're wearing those big shoes. I'm really sorry, but you have to keep walking. Turn back around, please. All sympathy can do, remember, what does sympathy say? Sympathy says, I'm sorry. Okay, keep walking, Richie. Sorry your book bag is so heavy this morning. Sorry those shoes are way too big for you. And a matter of fact, let's add one more thing. Now you just got detention. So hold that for me. You got that? You got it? Come on. So remember, sympathy says what? I'm sorry. So all sympathy. Remember, I'm sympathy, Richie's empathy, and he's holding what? Life. So keep walking, Richie. Richie, I'm so sorry you got detention. I'm so sorry you're carrying this book bag. It's so heavy. And I'm sorry those shoes are so big for you. I'm really sorry. So now, stop right there. So what does empathy do? Not only does it say I'm sorry, but now empathy comes and says, Richie, I see you're really struggling. Can I help you with this? And a matter of fact, if I can handle more than you can, let me hold this for you. So here's empathy and sympathy. Richie is now having to deal with something, and I come along and say, let me help you. That's what empathy does for someone. When you have empathy, that means you see that they're struggling, you see that they're hurting, and you stop and say, can I help you? So if I were to ask you today, what do you choose? Would you rather sympathy or empathy? What would you say? I can't hear you. What would you want? Empathy, right? Thank you. Give it up for Richie. You can take the shoes off, bud. So I hope that you guys understand that when you're in school, when you're in the grocery store, when you're home, those size, I think they're size 11. They're not mine. I don't like them. I don't wear ugly shoes. So when you're in life, when you're in school, everyone here has a life they have to deal with. Everyone here has stuff they have to put up with. Everyone here has to go through things. And if you take the time to ask your friends and you see that they're sad, you see that your teacher's sad, you see that your mom and dad are having a rough day, or someone on the street might need some help, rather than give them sympathy and say, I'm sorry, try your best to give them empathy. Can we try that today? So I have a question. I want to show you something. And this is something really cool that I've realized. So can someone tell me, what is this a picture of? Right here. Up here, look at the screen. What is this? What is this picture of? Everyone say iPad? All right, Richie, grab a seat. Miss Petrini has the chocolate, the kiss for you somewhere. Give it up for Richie again. Good job, Richie. What is this picture of? So we have iPad, iPhone, watch. So everyone stay with me. iPad. iPhone. I watch. iPhone. I watch. iPad. So, I have a question. Why do you think Apple made the phone have an I? Why does it have an iPhone, iPad, iWatch? Why did they give that name I? What was so great about the I? What do you think? Why does all those things have an I in front of it? Anyone? What do you think? Let me ask someone else. My friend over here with the, yes, headband, red shirt. Why is there an I in front of the phone, the iPad, and the watch? Make sense together? Okay, anyone else? Anyone else? Why is there an I? You. Because it's an iPhone. But see, Apple, okay, Apple understood that if they put an I in front of a phone, they put an I in front of a pad, and an I in front of a watch, it made sure that you knew that you are the most important part of that phone, that iPad, and that watch. So remember, the I is the most important thing. So I'm going to challenge you guys today. Before I'm going to give you a little song to hear, I'm going to sing to you today. I want you guys to try and do eye empathy. Can everyone say eye empathy?
Eye empathy!
So when you see an iPad, an iPhone, an iWatch, remember, the greatest thing about those iPhones, iPads, and iWatch is you. Without them, they're nothing. So Apple knew what they were doing by saying I. So if I challenge you here today, Rossi, to say eye empathy, I want you to go the extra step. Try and put on the shoes of someone else, understand what they're going through, and not only say, I'm sorry, but I'm here to help. Can we do that?
Yeah.
All right. So I guess I'm supposed to sing now?
Yeah.
All right, let's sing. Can I sing to you guys real quick?
Yeah.
All right. It's way too early, but I'm gonna do it because you guys are phenomenal. You guys have been awesome. Awesome, awesome. Can we try one more time? Clap one time if you hear me. Clap two times if you see me. Clap three times if you hear me and see me. All right, let's see how we get this to work now. Phenomenal. Thank you for coming to join me today. And remember to try to always show empathy.
Keep your faith and a friendship that will never end. When you are weak, I will be strong, helping you to carry on. Calm on me, I will be there. Don't be afraid. Counting on, I can see it's hurting you. I can feel your pain. It's hard to see the sunshine through the rain. I know sometimes it seems as if it's never gonna end. Just don't give in, 'cause you can count on me. I will be there, a friendship that will never end. When you are weak, I will be strong, helping you to carry on. Call on me, I will be there. Don't be afraid. Please believe me when counting on, you can count on me.
Can you guys just wave your hands side to side?
I know sometimes. will be there. A friendship that would never end. When you are weak, I will be strong, helping you to carry on. On me, I will be there. Don't be afraid. So please believe me when I say, count on. There's a place inside of both of us that our hearts can begin. If you lay aside the truth and love and act within. Although life can make you feel you're much harder than it gets, but you'll get through it. Just don't give in. Oh, count on me, I will be there. A friendship that will never end. When you are weak, I will be strong, helping you to carry on. Call on me, I will be there. Don't be afraid. So please believe me when I say, count on.
You guys are awesome, 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 amazing school. Remember to I empathy in all that you do and all that you say. Have an awesome day. Thank you for having me.